Welcome again to the CSEET program from Ekcel Academy. In today's class, we are going to shift a little out of grammar and talk to you about reading comprehension. In reading comprehension, we have certain assumptions and inferences. So, how do you identify assumptions and inferences, and how do you handle those questions? So, this lecture is devoted to these topics. So, first we are going to focus on assumption, but before we go into assumption, we will actually understand how reading comprehension passages are designed, or even critical reasoning or verbal ability passages are designed. Basically, there is a premise, then you have assumptions, and then you have conclusion. So, basically these are the three things that consists of a paragraph or a passage. Now, for example, I will give you a sentence and you tell me, does it come under premise, assumption, or does it come under conclusion? So, the sentence is, so he is buying a new car. So, he is buying a new car. Is this a premise, an assumption, or a conclusion? It is a conclusion, basically because it tells you about the final decision. What is the decision? To buy a car. So, this is conclusion. Now, if somebody asks you, why is he buying a new car? Do you have an answer for that based on what is written on the board? No, you don't have an answer. So, when in your reading comprehension, they ask you for a premise, premise is basically the first thing that leads to the conclusion, something that happens first. For example, here I will write, my friend's car met with an accident. So, my friend's car met with an accident, so he is buying a new car. In a sense, it gives you a complete meaning. It tells you that a friend's car met with an accident and then he has decided to buy a new car. So, so far you have the premise and you have the conclusion. Now, to find the question in your reading comprehension, you will have a question, what is the premise? To know the premise, all that you have to do is look at the conclusion and ask why. Look at the conclusion, is buying a new car, just ask why. Why is he buying a new car? Then you look at the options, and from among the option, the most legitimate, the strongest sentence that tells you that this could be a reason that he is buying a car will be your premise. So, now you have a clear understanding of what is a premise and what is a conclusion. Now, if I ask you this question, is this a good decision? What's your answer? As a layman, most probably somebody will say, it's not my money, it's my friend's money, it's his decision, why am I bothered? But in your logical reasoning, you have to find a reason to either say that this decision is a good decision or a bad decision. If you ask me, that is this a good decision? My answer is, I don't know. If you ask me why I don't know, my answer is, I don't have any details to tell you that if this is a good decision or a bad decision. Now, imagine you have a question that says, strengthen the argument. Now, when you are asked to strengthen the argument, it means you are supposed to believe that this person always makes good decision. For example, somebody in your family or a friend of yours who is known to make good decisions, who is known to make good decisions. So, when he comes and says, you know, he is making this decision, it is safe for you to believe that this person is making a good decision, because his past track record gives you that guarantee, it gives you that assurance that he is a good decision maker. So, when they ask you to strengthen the argument, you have to find from among the options a legitimate reason that will say that this decision is good. I will give you an example. My friend's car met with an accident and it cannot be repaired. My friend's car met with an accident and it cannot be repaired. So, legitimately, what is the best thing to do? He has to buy a new car. Now, this very statement tells you that this decision is good. I will give you another example. My friend's car met with an accident. So, we remove this for a while and we give you another assumption. And the cost of repair is as good as buying a new car. So, my friend's car met with an accident and for sure it can be repaired, but the cost of repair is so huge that you can buy a new car. So, what is the best decision? Get your old car, a damaged car repaired and pay a huge amount, or the best choice is to say, okay, it costs so much, as well as I buy a new car. So, this assumption also supports the decision of buying the new car. So, this would be the question that asks you to strengthen. So, when they ask you to strengthen, you look at the premise, you look at the conclusion, and then you see what is it that will support the premise and the conclusion. That is an assumption that strengthens the argument. Now, if somebody asks you to weaken the argument, the premise will be the same, the conclusion will be the same, but when they ask you to weaken the argument, what you are supposed to do, unlike strengthening where you believe that this person makes good decision, in this situation, you have to believe that this person always makes horrible decision. So, as well as this decision is also bad. So, how do you weaken this? You have the premise the same, you also have the same conclusion, but how do we weaken it? I am going to change this sentence and put a different sentence and let's see, is this decision a good decision or a bad decision?